Chapter 7, A Lesson from Christ's Labors.
On one occasion, while Christ was in the midst of his work of teaching and healing, one of the company assembled about him said, "Master, speak to my brother, that he divide the inheritance with me." Luke 12:13. This man had witnessed Christ's wonderful works. He had been astonished at the clearness of his comprehension, his superior judgment, and the fairness with which he viewed the cases brought to him. He heard Christ's stirring appeals and his solemn denunciations of the scribes and Pharisees. If words of such command could be spoken to this brother, he would not dare to refuse the aggrieved man his portion. He solicited Christ's influence on his side. "Speak to my brother," he said, "that he divide the inheritance with me." The Holy Spirit was pleading with this man to become an heir of the inheritance that is uncorruptible and undefiled, and that fadeth not away. He had seen evidence of the power of Christ. Now the opportunity was his to speak to the great teacher, to express the desire uppermost in his heart. But like the man with the muckrake in Bunyan's allegory, his eyes were fixed on the earth. He saw not the crown above his head. Like Simon Magus, he valued the gift of God as a means of worldly gain. The Savior's mission on earth was fast drawing to a close. Only a few months remained for him to complete what he came to do in establishing the kingdom of his grace. Yet human greed would have turned him from his work to take up the dispute over a piece of land. But Jesus was not to be diverted from his mission. His answer was, "Man, who made me a judge or a divider over you?" See Luke 12:14. Christ gave the man plainly to understand that this was not his work. He was striving to save souls. He was not to be turned aside from this to take up the duties of a civil magistrate. How often today labor is forced upon the church that should never be allowed to enter the work of the gospel ministry. Again and again Christ had been asked to decide legal and political questions, but he refused to interfere in temporal matters. He knew that in the political world there were iniquitous proceedings and great tyranny, but his only exposure of these was the proclamation of Bible truth. To the great multitudes that thronged his steps, he presented the pure, holy principles of the law of God and spoke of the blessing found in obeying these principles. With authority from on high, he enforced the importance of justice and mercy, but he refused to become entangled in personal disputes. Christ stood in our world as the head of the great spiritual kingdom that he came to our world to establish, the kingdom of righteousness. His teaching made plain the ennobling, sanctifying principles that govern this kingdom. He showed that justice and mercy and love are the controlling powers in Jehovah's kingdom.